Paranormal is a term used to define anything that cannot be measured or explained by science. These can include sightings of ghosts, UFOs, or psychic abilities. Supernatural activity is one of the longest existing phenomena, with research dating as far back as the 16th century with the England witch trials. It appears that the place of the supernatural has changed. However, what we plan to look at is how it is only our attitudes that have changed and not our relationship with the supernatural. The place of the investigator in the supernatural environment is developing in modern Britain. People are paying money to participate in these events, and investigators are finding themselves at the forefront of ever-growing media attention and web-based community.
Mr. Court, if you're still here with us, or anybody that's with Mr. Court, could you just let us know that you are here? Please. I'm sorry that we keep on asking, but we just need to know.
James and Andrew have been running a supernatural touring business for over 2 years. We met with them to find out how this interest has affected their company.
The paranormal industry has changed quite a lot over the past few years, just down to TV shows that are very popular at the moment. And we found that even for our Twitter page, which is just about Supernatural UK, we're finding that people are joining who love the TV show Supernatural, which is good, but it sort of still highlights us, but it's very different to what we do. And yeah, you do get a lot of people involved now because they've seen it on TV and want to try it for themselves. And when I started doing this, it was basically a very quiet industry, and since Live and TV have done it, it's obviously heightened the interest in it and become very popular.
Holy shit. Come up here quick, I need to use the CP!
Blair Witch Project shows the power of what media attention can do to people's beliefs about myths. Before the movie was released, producers handed out flyers of all three cast members claiming them to be missing, and the Internet Movie Database added a date of death to the very much alive cast members. This hype, along with the online interest, created a mass audience that drew $240 million in box office profits. Is this proof that we still fear anything that we cannot explain? Or are we now beings that get gratification from the unknowing of the supernatural world? Peter Collins, a paranormal investigator, explains why audiences want to participate in such activity.
Well, I think that people like to come along to experience paranormal nights or ghost hunting nights due to the onset of TV programmes such as Most Haunted and Taps, and also people's interest in other programmes like Buffy the Vampire Slayer and programmes like that, and Ghost Whisperer, is because they want to come along and experience it for themselves. They see so much equipment, they see the mediums working on these shows. So I believe that people do want to come along just to find out for themselves and experience the whole idea of having a paranormal investigation in an alleged haunted building.
We go back to James and Andrew, and with their help we take a look at how common supernatural phenomena is and how paranormal activity exists everywhere, including our very own home county.
Okay, well, we're in Hampshire, which is one of the UK's most haunted spots. We've got places like Netley Abbey and Tudor House and Royal Victoria Country Park, and there are a few stories with this particular location that the hospital mysteriously burned down. There was blames that it was done intentionally because at the time the new hospital, which is Southampton General, was opening up, and the rumour was that it was burned down intentionally to do too much damage for the building to be repaired.
Construction for the Netley Hospital in Victoria Country Park began in 1856. It was a prominent hospital during the First World War, and the hospital was often visited by Queen Victoria. There have been many sightings from the public of a ghostly apparition which stems from folklore of a nurse who worked in the hospital. She fell in love with a wounded soldier. Tragically, she accidentally overdosed him, resulting in his death. So distraught with grief and guilt, she jumped from a window at the top of the hospital, resulting in her suicide. 17th century England. Against the backdrop of a bloody English Civil War and social upheaval, Matthew Hopkins revelled in the climate of fear and uncertainty, claiming lives of innocent women for the crime of witchcraft in the name of God.
Take them.
In a matter of 2 years, the witchfinder General Hopkins tried and prosecuted over 300 women for witchcraft at the profit of 20 shillings a witch. 4 centuries later, instances of supernatural still generate a revenue.
Hi, I'm Craig. They call me the beloved leader, and so they should. I designed the site, I built the community, and we've been here for quite some time now, one of the longest communities on the internet.
Husband and wife team Craig and Jane Hamilton Parker charge £1.50 a minute for the privilege of speaking to trained psychics.
Craig and Jane Hamilton Parker.
So many I'd like to go to. I think I'll go for the lady in the white, if I may, please. Yes, yes.
Have you had a reading before?
No.
Yeah, I
feel I've got your grandmother here. Would you accept that?
Yes.
And I feel very much as if she's very much coming round you at this period of time in your life to protect you. Would you understand that?
Yeah.
Because everything is...
Rising popularity through the media has allowed attitudes to the supernatural to change, but the very nature of the field has changed very little. People still use supernatural to claim fame and gain fortune, even if their links to supernatural are self-imposed and fraudulent.
With frauds, I must admit, I only actually believe 99% of the paranormal things that actually happen, because you always got to get a 1% that's out there where people will fake things, and the main reason is to get money. For example, you could have a medium on stage and he could pick out and say, I've got a person called Jack who was in World War II. Someone that's definitely going to put their hand up. But also another good case is, for example, a medium could say to a person, oh, I feel that you're going on holiday. Now, of course, a person could say either, no, I'm not. So a medium could say, well, I feel like you need one and you are. Or the person could say, oh, yeah, I am. How did you know? So therefore, a medium can say it's spirit. So obviously, my job as a medium makes it a lot harder because of the fakes out there.
The business sector has benefited from this increasing interest, and the paranormal investigative community appears to be stronger and ever expanding. The Blair Witch Project is one of the most profitable movies of all time and is considered to be the first movie to market itself on the web. Human attitudes towards the supernatural have changed dramatically over the years, but the place of supernatural activity within society appears to have stayed exactly the same.